the astronauts say, on that little blue dot, there's two people fighting over parking space. And that's two countries fighting over parking space. What do you think about when you play? I said, try to play what you wish for. Play how you wish the world to be. And some people say, oh, that's too deep. But I'm 82 now. I ain't got nothing to lose by whatever I say.
You're watching Jazz Night in America. I'm Christian McBride. Wayne Shorter is a living legend, a saxophonist, composer, and lifelong original thinker.
In school, I knew people kind of looked up at me funny, the classmates. When I first got a clarinet, I painted, called myself Mr. Weird.
Lucky for us, Wayne was never afraid to be different, and that audacity helped him push jazz to new places.
It's not a mandate that jazz has to be ding, 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 for eternity.
Today, it's really hard to overestimate what he's done for the music. While Wayne takes us downstairs, let's lay out a few of his major claims to fame. Musical director for Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers, player and composer for Miles Davis's Quintet, co-founder of the jazz fusion band Weather Report, winner of 10 Grammys, including one for Lifetime Achievement.
Behind you.
You could say he's a collector. He's a lover of fantasy and science fiction. We open this episode of space for a reason.
Because that multiverse doesn't reveal any resemblance of the laws that exist here, quantum and all that stuff.
This is a jazz musician who ponders the bending of space-time. Don't believe me? It's on his t-shirt. When Wayne Shorter plays, he brings all these influences to the table. And trust me, it's a rare and exquisite mix. So, let's get to the music. In May 2015, Wayne played a show with the Jazz and Lincoln Center Orchestra. The concert featured tunes written by Wayne and arranged by orchestra members. Everybody considered it an honor to be in the hall that night.
We're not going to belabor it too much. We have a true master tonight. 6 decades of unequaled excellence. Sitting right up here with us, playing all kinds of music, songs that he wrote, we've had the honor of arranging. It's with great, great pleasure that we welcome a genius and master, Mr. Wayne Shorter.
Thank you.
That tune was Yes or No. This is the original recording, done in 1964. The big band version we just heard is quite a bit different. And that raises a jazz paradox. We fall in love with classic recordings, but good musicians never stop reinventing their own sound. So in a way, 2015 Wayne has to confront 1964 Wayne every time he plays.
It's almost like doing an acting job. And sometimes people feel, might assume, that since you've done something 20, 30 years ago, that you can just do it that same way. But since you have moved on and you have a new layered ideas and muscle memory, it's almost like asking an adult to go outside and play with some other adults like they used to do when they were kids.
Wayne isn't one to rest on his laurels. As a Nietzschean Buddhist, he has a healthy view of his own success, one that he sums up in three words.
Honnim-yo, it means from this moment forward is the first day of my life. And then we don't rely and sit on awards and trophies, Grammys, and this and that. That's the worst kind of fuel that you can rely on. The best kind of fuel that you can rely on is honnim-yo, you start from now. Because the present moment is the only time where you can create change. In the present moment is where you can change the past and the future.
Sounds a little bit like bending space-time. Anyway, let's take Wayne's advice and start from now. I'll let Wynton Marsalis take it from here.
And the rest of us. Now we'd like to play a piece that was recorded in 1961. Wayne says it is concerned with the need for time for contemplation, especially when you're on the road or when you do any repetitive work that you can do by rote. This piece is about realizing what your mission is, contemplating your mission and embracing it. This is a beautiful piece entitled Contemplation. It's been arranged by Mr. Sherman Irby. Thank you.
That was Contemplation, written by Wayne Shorter and arranged by Sherman Irby. Think about that. You're a member of the orchestra. You're asked to take apart and reassemble a composition by one of your idols. Then you have to present that new arrangement to him and perform it on stage beside him. Easy, right?
When you first come in a room and you do an arrangement of somebody's music and they're there to kind of critique it, It can be a little concerning, but he was just fabulous.
He was very supportive and very much a part of the group and not like this icon standing on top of everybody saying, you know, this is my music, this is how I do it. It was none of that attitude. So it was like he was one of the guys.
You somehow, I don't know, you maybe anticipate that they're going to be someone else, that they're not going to be the person that inspired you, they're going to disappoint you, or they're going to not be as good, or he's 80, 81 years old, maybe he doesn't have the technique or the ears. None of that is true. He was everything that he was years ago.
He didn't have any requests for changes of anything, amazingly, as I reflect upon it. He was able to take what we had, even though he hasn't played some of those tunes in decades, I'm sure, and interpret them and make them just as fresh as anything that was being written today.
Wayne is very deep. He understands the spirituality in the music.
He's still moving the music forward, even at in his 80s, which is what we all hope to be able to do, but he is actually executing that quite well.
And he's not out to try to prove anything to anybody else, just make good music. And there's a lesson there to be learned from that.
Here's a piece that Wayne Shorter recorded first in 1985. It was the 80s, and the original recording had a lot of synthesizers. Tonight's arrangement was done by trombonist Vincent Gardner.
Center Orchestra. It has been our great honor and pleasure to play with the one and only, the legendary Wayne Shorter.
What a show. Wayne Shorter is one bad man. You can hear more music and a deeper dive into Wayne's Buddhism on our radio show. Check your local radio listings or visit npr.org/jazznight. I'm Christian McBride, and thanks for watching.
We'd like to thank you all very, very much for coming out tonight. We hope you've enjoyed yourselves here in the House of Swing. We're up in here. Great.